Good evening. It's good to see my church family tonight. Trust you had a wonderful Sunday afternoon. Maybe took a Sunday nap. Maybe even took a walk today. It was a beautiful, beautiful day today. These are just these kind of Sundays, the bright skies, the blue skies, the bright sun, all that's like a recharge kind of Sunday. And I just love those kinds of days. We're all standing as we're opening up the service in prayer. It's good to be in the house of God tonight. Heavenly Father, we're so thankful to be here tonight. Lord, I pray that you'd please use this service for your glory. Pray that you would please speak to us tonight. And would you be with in every aspect of the service? May you use it all for your honor. And we'll thank you for what you do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Brother Stratton is coming to lead us in our singing.
All right, take your chorus books and turn to song number 376. Song number 376, while the ages roll, I'll keep on praising him. Sounds like you're getting warmed up here tonight, ready to sing praises to the King. Praise his name. Let's turn to song number 225. Jesus will outshine them all. You may be seated. Number 225.
Thank you.
Amen. Praise his name. Who will be first to give the Lord praise tonight? Or maybe you have a song you'd like to sing.
Quoted it, but I'll mess the quote up, but I really appreciated what it meant to me. It was that peace makes an awfully soft pillow to sleep on, and it dawned on me this week that joy is an awfully good breakfast to get up to. I appreciate what the Lord means to me and how he's changed my life and changed my mindset, my heart, just changed my attitude. Amen. And just I wouldn't want to live any other way. I appreciate what he means to me.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Thank the Lord for everything he does today. Tomorrow will be my 30th year spiritual anniversary. Not in May, but it's April the 15th. The last day that you can do your taxes on that day. I can remember that. Well, I remember. I thank the Lord for what he's doing for me, how he's guided and directed through all the trials and all the temptations and everything that comes my way. Jesus is always there. He's a gentleman. He doesn't try to, or he doesn't put a rope around my neck and to drag me away from what I shouldn't get into. He sits back and he watches. He watches me, and he wants to see what I will do about the situation or the circumstance. And every time I get to that point in my life, I have to tell the devil that Jesus died on the cross for me. He shed his blood. I trust in him. He's my Savior. Amen. I got rid of you a long time ago. You have no right in my life anymore. But I feel some people feel this through trials and temptations and things like that. But Jesus never left me. He never forsake me. Good. He's the best friend I have. I love him tonight. And my biggest goal that I have right now is to make heaven my home.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm sorry? 344. All right. Prayer tonight to be more like him. Praise his name. Somebody else.
Wonderful to serve Jesus. There's no better way to live than to live for him. Have his sweet peace in your soul and the just thinking this week, the Lord just met with me so many different times throughout my devotions this week and ministered to my heart. And I just want to draw closer to Him. I'm glad for the promise that He says that if you draw nigh to God, He'll draw nigh to you. And I found that true in my life, and I praise Him tonight.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Right across the page, 341. This world never gave me the peace that I have. His name. Did I hear a song number? Number 22. 22. Okay. Okay, we've got two songs here. We'll start with number 22 and then we'll go to 322 after that. All right. Number 22.
Jesus is the way to my Father.
There's joy in serving Jesus.
Amen.
Praise his name.
Amen.
All right, so.
That verse 4 says, peace and love abides in my Father's house. And make me think again, years ago we had a sale, and many years ago. And then it was over time. I'd go to Middleburg Auction a lot, and this old man used to come, and his son was the auctioneer at the sale, at our sale one time. He says, "Oh, yeah, you know, how's it feel to be rich? It's nice to be rich." And this seems every time I went there. And just because you had a sale don't mean you're rich. I want to put that in there. But what I want to say is, I got tired of that. I got tired of that. And I finally stood him right to the face and I said, I want to tell you something. I says, I don't have much money, but I got love in my home. I got peace in my heart. And I have a marriage and we're in love and we have a family and we have love now. And he said, money can't buy that. And I agree.
Amen.
There's love in my Father's house.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Keegan, what was your song? 322. All right. Number 322. The old rugged cross made the difference.
T'was a lie.
praise the Lord. Let's sing that first verse again. I like that last line. It says, just one touch, and then a new life began. I'm thankful for the touch of God tonight. Praise God. 'Twas a life filled with aimless desperation. Tonight. I'm glad the cross has made a difference in my life. Amen. Every heart clear this evening. Someone else have a testimony on your heart. Praise God. Go right ahead.
Well, this week I want to praise God for, I had a pretty nasty fall. I got minor injuries, but it could have been a whole lot worse. I praise God. Thank you.
Amen. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Anyone else tonight? Praise God. Amen. It sure is good to see my grandpa this evening in church. I took a picture of him getting out of his car, and I was all excited to see him here. And I sure am grateful for what the Lord's done for him. And what's your favorite song? Papa, Darvin, do you have a favorite song you'd like to sing? All right, let's see. Let's try across the page 325. I think you'll like this one. Then I Met the Master, 325.
Like a babe. Yeah.
glad I have light in my pathway because I met the Master. Praise God. Anyone else tonight? Every heart clear. Amen. Right. Praise God. The Lord. Praise God. Amen. Thank God.
Praise his name. I'm so thankful for the Master and that I met him. And, you know, I don't know what I would do without him, and I don't want to know. I'm so thankful for Jesus tonight and all that he means to me. He's my anchor. He's my hope. He's just everything to me. And I just hold on to him as tightly as I know how. And I'm just so thankful for his love and for all that he's doing for me, for what he's doing for my family, for my children.
Amen.
I'm just so very grateful, and I just love him with all my
Amen.
Heart.
Praise Amen. God. Thank the Lord. Anyone else? Praise God. Praise God. Thank the Lord. Great convention, powerful preaching. And if you didn't get to go and have not had a chance to look at some of those services, you can go online and do so. And I promise you, your heart will be encouraged. You'll be encouraged, even by Sister Schaefer's speech. I don't know if we'll call it a sermon, but even by her speech. Your heart, I think, will be encouraged. It will be. I even went back and watched it. She did a great job. Praise God. Well, let's go to the Lord in prayer this evening. If you have your bulletin, you see the various needs that are in front of you. And we do want to be praying for Sister Jeannie Mowry. Was talking to Brother Mowry on his way in tonight, and she is just really struggling in a lot of pain, even this evening. And so we're going to be praying for her this evening, praying for Sister Castor, and that God will continue to be close to her. And it is peaceful being was able to visit with her even this afternoon, and just peaceful being there with her, knowing that everything's right with God and she's ready to go. And there's just nothing better than knowing that you're ready for heaven and ready to see God face to face. But let's be praying for Sister Castor and her family in a special way as well. Emily Hartman continues to need our prayers. She's home from the hospital. Thelma Ryan has a procedure this week. We've been praying for Brother Gordon Alexander, praying for Tiffany Stahl. And in fact, she's going to be coming forward to be anointed this evening here in just a few moments. And so we'll ask some of you ladies to gather in with her. But continuing to pray for these other individuals that have battling sickness and different things. Been thinking of Brother Gary Basem today, and so let's be praying for him. It's good to see Shirley Spurka here tonight, this morning as well, but we've been praying for her as well. There are some families that are grieving, and a funeral service that'll be here at our church on Friday for the Goldie Moyer family. So let's be praying for these families. A graveside service tomorrow for the Mary Schroeder family. Let's be praying for them as well as these other families. Do you have any specific requests tonight that is not on here that you'd maybe like to mention? Okay. Pray for Janelle Keaton this evening. Okay. All right. We'll be praying for this one. Yes. All right, Sister Tiffany is going to come forward to be anointed this evening. If some of you ladies would gather in with her, and the rest of us, let's stand together this evening if you're at all able, and let's pray out and ask God to meet these needs tonight. He is able this evening for each one of these. Let's pray. You join me. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight. Lord, you know about each and every one that is here this evening. God, you see every concern that might be on hearts tonight. You see our church, and Lord, we're here. We're doing our best to be a light for you, to shine our beacon brightly. And Lord, I ask, would you help us as individuals to be able to do so as well? God, you see our church family tonight, those that are grieving, those that are going through difficult times, those that are facing battles, even physically. Lord, you know what they are. Would you undertake, be with those that have procedures and surgeries this week? Oh God, we ask for your will to be accomplished in each one of these, and may you give the strength and give peace throughout these situations, Lord. God, you know tonight about Sister Castor. Lord, oh God, how good it is to know that she's ready for heaven. God, she's done her best to live her life for you. And Lord, you're there walking this road, this part of the journey with her. And we know you're going to help her. We know you're going to meet her need this evening. Would you wrap her up in your loving arms, Jesus, and surround her family with prayer this evening as well. God, you know about every situation. We think of Brother Gary Basem tonight. Would you draw close to him? Give him a special touch tonight. You think of our shut-ins this evening. Lord, you see each and every one of them. Be with Sister Swengel tonight. Would you touch her in a special way and draw close to her, Jesus? You know the situation there, and we just trust you and know that you're able to give help and strength. And every single one of those that aren't able to be out tonight, some that are home and sick and no doubt watching online, God, would you speak to them right there where they're at? May they sense your presence drawing close. We're thankful tonight for the touch that comes from above. Just one touch, Lord, and the work can be completed. One touch in our lives when we were lost and dying spiritually, Lord. One touch changed our lives, and we thank you for that touch tonight. We know that you're able. Lord, continue to be with us in this service this evening. We'll be careful to give you all the glory, the honor, and praise. We love you tonight for all that you do for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
Splendor than them, consider. Thank you for that good song. I'm grateful that God watches over us. We're asking the ushers if they would prepare to receive the offering. And while they're preparing, I want Brother Belts to come. It's a privilege to have him with us all the time. But he has an announcement that he would like to make about the upcoming school year. Brother Belts.
Well, it's hard to believe that we are entering the last marking period of the school year at Pennview Christian Academy. And with that comes a lot of end-of-the-year activities and preparations. And part of that is getting ready for the next school year. In fact, put this on your calendar. Registration is 4 months from today, August 14th, Academy registration. And we're excited about that. But a little bit closer to home is this coming Thursday, April 18th, is our pre-K and kindergarten registration. That happens at from the hours of 12 to 3, Thursday afternoon, right there in our elementary building. We invite all prospective preschool and kindergarten students to come with their families, visit the classroom, meet our teacher. We'll get some information in your hands. For frame of reference, for preschool, meets 2 days a week, Tuesday and Thursday morning, and the student should be age 4 by September 1st. Our kindergarten meets 3 days a week, all day, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and they should be age 5 by September 1st of this year. If you have any questions, feel free to see me after the service or contact me at the school during the week. We look forward to all that God's doing there at Pennview. Thank you.
Amen. We wanted Brother Belts to make that announcement. We appreciate our school. I guess I do have one question. I'll have to ask him later. Do they have to weigh so much? Because my kindergartner who's going this year weighs 29 pounds, and I'm not sure if that's acceptable or not. Maybe the school lunches will fatten her up. We appreciate our Christian Academy and Brother Belts and all of you who work there and participate and send your kids. Well, we thank God for it. Let's pray for this offering. I'm going to ask Brother Richard Yoder if he would pray. And thank you so much for your faithful giving tonight. All right, Brother Forney, Brother Gandy are coming to minister to us in song, and then Pastor Plank is going to be bringing the evening message. Let's continue to mind God in this service.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Would you stand with us, please, for the reading of God's word from the book of Isaiah, chapter 35. Isaiah, chapter 35. Our text tonight will be verse 8. Isaiah 35 and verse 8. Isaiah 35 and verse 8. And an highway shall be there and a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those the wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein. No lion shall be there, nor any ravenous beast shall go up thereon. It shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy upon their heads. And they shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Shall we pray? Father in heaven, we thank you for this service, the opportunity to be here. I pray you'd give us the anointing of the Holy Ghost tonight and accomplish your purpose with preacher and people. And for what you do, we'll praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Back before the days of GPS and maps on your phone. Do you remember those days? You can go all the way back to like Sister Herrick's day before Rand McNally and before the interstate system in the United States. How many ever heard of the automobile blue book? I'm not talking about Kelly's blue book that talks about the value of your car. I'm talking about the old automobile blue book. Larry Kratz, I almost think you're the one that told me about it, aren't you? You have one, and so after you told me about it, I bought one on eBay. They are so neat. Now, this is way back before GPS, way back before AAA, way back before the interstate system and when roads were all numbered. And this book, you got to see it. It tells you, you know, if I wanted to go from Harrisburg to Williamsport, let's say, it'll tell you, you know, to turn at a covered bridge. And then you go 3 miles and there'll be a white picket fence. And at the end of that fence, you turn right. And you go up that road about 3 miles and there'll be a big oak tree. And you turn left there and you go, this is how this was all across America, these various volumes. Depending what area of the country you wanted to travel, you got one of these automobile blue books. It told you where you might be able to find a gas station. This is back You know, when we were just getting rid of horses and getting vehicles, most interesting thing you've ever seen. Now, by the time I came along in life and discovered America, we did not have GPS yet. We did not have phones. You know, I'm hooked on my phone now, and it's a sad thing in the sense of directions. I can't hardly get from here to Mifflinburg without putting on Waze. That's my favorite direction place. Well, I can get to Mifflinburg, but there's a few other places I have to have directions on my phone. Back then, if we went on a vacation, Dad would go to AAA. If we were going to go on a vacation, it was a big deal. We were going to drive to Florida, let's say. We went to AAA and got a triptych. Anybody remember triptychs? Yeah, they put together. You gave them a notice, and then you'd go back into AAA, and they'd have this bound thing they made just for you, with your route highlighted, with all the interesting things to see along the way, and a series of spiral-bound maps with the starting place and the destination. And I got to thinking about vacations and those triptychs and that old automobile blue book and my Waze app on my phone. And I thought of this Bible as being the best GPS that you can ever hope for that will take us. We are not left helpless and hopeless in this world. We have a GPS, a triptych, an automobile blue book that will take us from this world into the next world. God calls it the highway of holiness. And in here, he tells you where to turn at the picket fence and where to turn at the oak tree. In fact, I'm convinced this is more clear than the old automobile blue book. This book, I think when you start down the road on the highway of holiness, the first place you come to would be the city of conviction. You can read about it in Acts chapter 2, verse 37. Peter is preaching, Acts 2:37, this verse. Now when they heard